So we are both from the Austin Center for Digital Humanities and Cultural Heritage at the Austin Academy of Sciences. And we are also involved in SHOC. So yeah, I will come to this later. So tried to make a structure of this presentation, and it's 4 points. So why we do use a vocabulary service, and why did we choose Cosmos for this? Yeah, so we also like to show the setup of this Cosmos instance here at ACDHCH, and also because that's a topic that we discovered and we think that's important, is this editing options, and we already heard about using the combinations Cosmos and Workbench, and we do decided for a different other way to do this. So first of all, we have two entry points for our vocabulary service, and they're the same, but they deal with a different audience, so to say. So the first one is vocabs at ACDH is about our vocabularies that we host and about the projects that we have in our institute. And the second is also the one to Daria, because our aim is also to serve the Daria community with a way to host vocabularies. And this is merged together. Yes, so I show you a screenshot of the vocab service. It looks quite same like other Cosmos instances. And you also see some of these vocabularies that we share. There are general ones, there are, and we have a focus on humanities. So that's also important to highlight here. Yes. I present you some of these use cases. One of these use cases are third-party funded projects where there are vocabularies created. Often this is also something that is about documentation of a project setting. So often it is a result of a project, and then we host this vocabulary. What's very important for us is our repository Arche. We use vocabularies for this repository, and that was also one of the initial points to start our vocabulary service and to use Cosmos. And that's also important because it deals with the workflow of preparing and documenting the stuff that we then put into long-term preservation. And there's also some experimental projects, I call them, where we deal a little bit with linked data environments, and we try to think about interoperability between projects and mapping of data. That's also where vocabularies are very helpful and where we use them. If you talk about the Daria community, we give an opportunity to host a vocabulary. The other idea is to have a kind of single access point for vocabularies from different domains of the humanities, of the arts and humanities. It's also something where the outcomes of Daria activities are shared. So there are working groups in Daria, and some of them produced vocabularies. In general, I think it's also important to say that Daria tries to support this use of vocabularies, and it's also a kind of contribution of Daria if you are in European-wide projects active. So SHOC could be one of these examples. So going into detail, so how this vocabulary service is used is sometimes already mentioned documentation. It's also very important that structured data is created, so that people use SCOS or projects instead of spreadsheets. That's very common to use spreadsheets, but we like to have them to create structured data, so that would be then SCOS. It's also about reuse of vocabularies. That's also important for us, and that's something that a lot of people or projects enjoy, is if you give them an autocomplete function where they can browse through in their project environment through vocabularies with the help of autocomplete and fill fields there. I think what's important also is that vocabularies can be a cross project connection points. That's something, this is also something that deals with reuse of vocabularies. Yes, so there are other stuff like statistics and so on. I'm not going there into deep. Yes, so we started with evaluation back in 2017. The main motivations were, as I already mentioned, Arche, our repository service, but also to push the use of vocabularies then. And the evaluation of vocabulary also started in 2017. So our results are based more on these 3 years ago. And based on this, we decided for Scosmos. So here are a list of tools that we tried then. You already heard it, some of them by Darren. Here's the criteria for our evaluation. So that was the support of the data models, also which triple stores can be connected. Then it was also important for us how the front end, the presentation layer looked like and how we can adapt it. Import, export of dumps, of cost dumps. Extremely important if there's an API available and is it a simple API to use. And back then, we also talked a lot about editors and user management for editors, because that was something where if there are a lot of projects involved, you like to have this kind of user management to separate projects, but they should then deliver their results into one service. Yes. So in the end, we decided for Scosmos, and one of the points we already mentioned. So I like to highlight this well-maintained API and the Swagger file there. So that is very helpful for applying other tools on this API or on Scosmos. It's also this good documentation and the good readable source code, and it's also important that it's open source. Yeah, we also liked the clear separation between the code and data, so that we have Scosmos on the one side and it doesn't touch the triple store. So that was also important for us. Yes. So and there are the minus points, but I go into them. I will talk a little bit about them later on. There is no integrated editor. There is no direct import-export. So that was some minus points for us. But if you look at the other tools, there was a general problem, or there is a general problem with this kind of editors. And one of these problems deal with these multiple users, how to deal with conflicts, how to deal with different versions, how to preserve the progress, the data, and so on. So we found out 3 years ago that other services that do have editors come with disadvantages. So we also decided for using Scosmos for the front end, so to say, and deciding for a different approach for editing vocabularies. Yes, so that's in short the setup of Scosmos, the current setup at Scosmos at our institute. So we also run on Apache Jena Fuseki, where we do have curators that do import or export or do Sparkle queries on this triple store. They also deploy a version of the vocabulary, a dump of the vocabulary into a repository. Ideally, it would be Arche, but we also have a GitHub repo. And this dump of vocabulary is then linked into Scosmos, so that it have this download there. And Scosmos here uses the Apache Jena Fuseki, so you already heard about this. So we have curators involved. That's I think very important. And what's also important for us is this API, and that there is a read-only access to the machines. Let's call them machines or other tools use this API. And if you go to this workflow of vocabs management, so we do have, so to say, a classical way. So we have three instances of Scosmos running. One is the test instance, that's only internal. You need to be in-house. You need to have this password where developers and designers try out their stuff. It uses the triple store internal, and vocabulary managers do put the triple store in an initial phase there to try out if everything is set up. Then we have this second instance, that's the Scosmos stage. That's already open to project. There's a password where you can get there. And as you see, it also uses this triple store internal. So we then switch, if we decide the initial phase is over and is all well set up, we switch then to this Scosmos stage instance. And the third instance is the production instance. That's the one that you get under the link in the beginning. So that's open to the public. And there we have a dedicated, also a dedicated triple store that's, so to say, exposed to the public. And what you also
Can,
see, yeah, please jump in.
If I can jump in, yeah, this, yeah, obvious probably, but the staging instance is meant for develop, yeah, for seeing vocabularies during the development of the vocabulary, so that when curators or a team is working on a vocabulary, then we repeatedly ingest it into this internal triple store, and it's visible through the staging instance, just for this closed circle of persons, so that because it kind of gives an impression of, yeah, how does it really look like? It's better to see it in SCOSMOS than to look at the raw SCOS file, so to say. So this is a nice kind of iterative process of refining the vocabulary and seeing how it looks like. And when we are fine with the version, then it goes to production.
Yes. So you also see in the cloud the vocabulary editor. That's something that I will that we will then talk about. And you see this vocabulary editor only works on this stage of test or on this Cosmos stage level. So there's no direct work on the exposed one, on the production one. So if we have changes in the vocabularies, we then do it at the staging, and then after this go to production. Okay. Let's talk about these editing options. And I mentioned here that it's still a weak point in our current setting. Maybe that's something for discussion later on. So on the one hand, we have projects that deliver their vocabularies in very different formats. And sometimes also we need to convince them that they do have vocabularies. So that's not always easy that they understand that they have a kind of vocabularies there. And then we need to convince them, or we try to convince them that they use COS, but that is not always fruitful, or they decide against this. So we do have a way of vocabulary management where we need to prepare, or where we need to map it, have scripts running, etc. Yes, the challenges I already mentioned. So what is also important for us is to have, it's important about this, to speak about quality and management of quality for these vocabularies. So if there are a lot of people involved in a project that work on a vocabulary, you run very quickly into these quality issues. So therefore our conclusion was to that without a dedicated vocabulary management or dedicated vocabulary managers that usually are on our side, it is not possible to guarantee this quality that we like to have and that we like to expose to others. And based on this conclusion, it's not so bad that Cosmos doesn't have an editor there, because we can control it in another way or in a different way and put these quality efforts into play. That means that vocabulary managers need to have a kind of burden that they need to solve. So they need to do this contact with project members, then this convincing this cost use, having this iteration cycle up to date, and vocabularies, depending on the project and the project phase, can change very quick. And it's also this kind of monitoring steadily the quality of all of the vocabularies that we host. In general, we have three ways how vocabulary development is handled. The one is that project members do have their own tools. So I mentioned here the spreadsheet, but that's very usual. And then we have this mapping and doing a script where we import it. Or create a cost dump and put them into the triple store. Very seldom project members or projects have the ability to create their scores by their own. So maybe they use a text editor or whatever. So they only hand over the dump to us. But the most asked option is the one to have a kind of editor, and therefore we developed in kind, so to say, or in-house vocabs editor service. So that's something that's Python Django based app, And there, so I will give you some screenshots how this works, and then you're already on the end of the presentation. And I also see that would be just in time. So that's in general what the VocaPS editor does, so very easily, it only creates, it allows you to create vocabularies, it allows you to create concepts, do this in multilingual way, and also have the ability to do collections. That's also something that we don't have these complicated vocabularies, so it works this way quite well. You need a user account, as I already mentioned. We have a user management here so that we can identify what happened at the vocabularies, so we can revert changes or whatever. So I give you some screenshots here. You see, you have a way to get an overview about the vocabularies and concepts that are in this VocaPS editor. You can create new concepts. Here's the example of a new concept where you can do this different way of Scosify all your stuff. And so in general, it's a kind of content management for Scos, and where we prepared these formulas and people can put their stuff inside. And the good thing is you can imagine that the fields there are based upon the data types that they expect, so we also have a kind of check here that the correct data is inserted. So there are some features. So it's possible to import and export SCOS dumps. We can do a lot of creation. We have this user management, content management. People do not know a lot about SCOS if they work with this VocaPS editor. You have a way to show everything in tables. That's sometimes expected by people, and to search. We have multilingual stuff there. We also can combine different metadata models. What's very important is the history of changes and the possibility to revert changes. We also have an API there where we can also do kind of visualization. And it's important to highlight here that it's not directly connected to Scosmos, so it does also not work natively on the Drupal store. There are different arguments why we choose this way, but yeah. So what we do here is we have this VocaPS editor, then people from our project enter their concepts there, and a vocabulary manager from our side then jumps into, does an export and imports in it into the Apache Jena Fusiki, and then it pops up in Cosmos.
Yes, I mean, while one could discuss having this publication workflow or step more automatized, I think that this is a deliberate decision that, and I think that's obvious, that the edition not every change in the vocabulary should be reflected in the published vocabulary. So there are kind of versions or snapshots that you produce. So you work for some time with many edits on a version, and then you explicitly have to decide, okay, this is a consolidated or kind of consistent version of the vocabulary which I want to publish. So I think that is kind of makes sense. And I wouldn't want to, must not mix that, I would say.
Okay. Super. That's it in short. So I point you to this further reading. It also tells you more background about our setting. So Xenia and Mati an introduction to controlled vocabularies and scores based on our setup. And here you have our contact emails and. Thank you.